delighted, get excited.
Maybe, but not a lot.
You're gonna see a whole lot of magic. Look at this trick and that trick. And when he says it's not a lot, you'll agree such a lot. Meet the man who excels, old Daniel.
Thank you. Thank you, jury. And thank you at home for tuning in to watch another one of the magic shows. And we hope you're going to enjoy it. Hope you like it. Not a lot, but I hope you like it. You see, we've already started by placing three of the jury members up here, standing there looking like the Three Stooges, aren't you? But don't worry, we're about to take part in the first miracle. In fact, it's a combination of miracle, a mixture of magic, a twosome of trickery. What's your name, sir?
Tom.
Tom, nice to meet you, Tom. So, Tom, you're going to take part in a twosome of trickery. It's getting worse. And your name is?
Mary.
Mary, nice to have you on the show, my love. Very nice to have you indeed on the show. Look at that. It's been annoying me since I walked over here. You just take that. Yes, sorry about that, Mary. Here, get hold of that. There you are. Now you're daft like all the rest of us. What's your name? Alan, nice to meet you, Alan. Now, I think we'll pick Tom because you're probably... forgive me walking in front of you, but I want to be near the counter here. We have here three plates. Those will come into use later on. But these three plates are important, all right? First of all, I'm just going to spread them out like this, and you can see that we have got the cleanest, whitest, pristinest plates we could ever get for you, Tom. And we're just going to put them together, and I want you to put them underneath the counter like this and mix them up. In other words, put one on the bottom, one on the top, one on the bottom, things like that, all right? So that no one could possibly know which order any of the plates are in. Okay? Right. Now, I will step over here and explain something. While Tom is in there chipping away at the plates... probably serve chips with everything in the restaurant he goes to. And now, just take them out. Okay, don't leave them on there. Take them out and deal them along the counter. Just one behind this one, one behind that one, one behind that one. All right? That's fantastic. Great. Now, we've shuffled the plates. I think it is also important we shuffle the people. Could you just shuffle yourselves, please? That's it. Have a quick shuffle. That's the idea. Come on, get in the shuffle. That's it. Keep going. It does nothing at all to do with the trick. It's just I like watching people make fools of themselves. Now, you just step over there, because I'm going to explain to our viewing audience about the rest of the trick. Now, to do this, watch this, folks. He gets undressed. Because this is going to be a very messy trick, one that children everywhere are going to love. We'll just fold that rather neatly, because it cost a fortune. And then what I'm going to do is just roll up my sleeves, because this is a trick that involves water. And I'm going to roll up my sleeves as soon as I can undo the button, which is quite difficult. So there is one. You're seeing this arm for the first time on BBC TV. Joe, what will he get up to next? On here is... punch bowl, but we filled it with water. We hope you can see that. We can just take this and just tip some of the water out. Look at that. All right, there we go. Now this is for one fantastic moment I thought it was gin. And, sad that, isn't it, really? But we're going to add this. Now this is sand, coloured sand. Now we're going to tip in the sand first of all. We tip in the yellow sand, and having tipped in the yellow sand, we're going to swirl it around a bit in the water so that it gets in nicely mixed in with the water like so. And having got it mixed in with the water, didn't I tell you this was a messy trick? We then add the red, of course. Oh, look at that, beautiful this. There we are, very colourful trick, but rather messy. Do try it at home, children, on the living room carpet. This is... mothers will be writing in. Who cares? Address your letters, children, to Terry Wogan, BBC. there's some night I don't care. And we take this, which is the final one, of course, and we add that. Now, there you have, I hope, a mixture, a muddy mixture of water, sand, all in together. All right? Now, we're going to give each of you some sand. And we would like you to do the sand dance made famous by Wilson, Keppel and Betty. And we hope you'll all be very happy together doing it. This is now, well, this feels awful. If anybody at home wants to try this, you're welcome to take over my job. Now you place this in the oven and cook slowly. And this is important. Now, this is important. I want you to just bring me over a plate. Will you bring me over? Yes, that's fine. Right. Now, we're going to take a plate. And just over here. Over here, right over, because right out the middle, I'm going to take a handful of sand. But the sand is going to be dry, and the sand is going to be all one colour, all right? So there's your first handful, all right? And that's blue sand separated from all the others. You're very good at this. Would you bring a plate over? Now, what I want you to do now is just hold it over the bowl, because this is not going to be easy. I've got to get a handful of sand for you. Let's give you this one, all right? Here we go, handful of sand, dry and yellow. Okay, so there we are. There we go. Would you just tip it that way, just a shade? Whoops, there we go. Great, fantastic. Thank you, John. Because we've got to just hold it over there, get a big handful, another handful. That's fantastic. We just take this out and we just hold it like that, and there you have it, a handful of red sand. So there we are, we've separated it out from all these colours in there. Now that's not really the trick. But what is fascinating is this. Step back, just step back a moment. Thank you. You see, here we have a plate full of yellow sand. And there's something I couldn't know, because you shuffled the plates and you shuffled yourselves, all right? So how did I know that this would be the plate that before the show we had marked yellow? Just take hold of that and stand there. This is the plate that before the show we had marked blue. Would you just take that and stand there? And this is the plate full of red sand that we had marked red. And now it's time for the magic set. This week with their version of Punch and Judy.
Hello, Punch. Tell me, Punch, what do you want?
A kiss.
You want an ice kiss. Just one second. Right, I'm ready. Give us an ice kiss, Punch.
Okay.
Oh, get off my back, Punch. You're very passionate. Anyway, Punch, what shall we do now? How about a nice dance? What a good idea!
Next guest is a juggler is an enormous understatement. As a boy, I idolized this man, and I'm very proud to have him as a guest on my show. From the great days of variety, will you please welcome the great Rob Murray.
Oh, there you are. Good God. I thought you'd gone away for a minute. Says here, put your foot there. Oh, well, never mind. Up we go. My God, look at that. That's amazing, isn't it? Ah, dear. Is Variety dead? Yes. Now I'm telling you, I didn't feel well when I came here. Oh, God. 75 years of hard practice for this. I'm not joking, this is ridiculous. Here's a good one, look. Oh, my God. No, it's all right. No sympathetic applause. The pension's coming due so shortly. Oh, pension. Oh, God. Oh, good God, did you see that? I didn't. I'll finish the little slot now. Oh, dear me. Oh, dear me. Four plates, I can only juggle three. They think the man's a genius in the place. Ah, dear. My God, this used to be a riot in Woolloomooloo. Three people and a kangaroo. God, hello. That was a lucky shot, wasn't it? Now, here we go. Three in the air at the same time. Simultaneously. Good show, lad. Turn round quickly and you cut your ears off at this bit. Oh. Now, here's a good one. This'll astound us all if it works. Oh, dear. This is it. Slight technical error there. There will be others as we go along. Two. Maybe three or four. Five or six, seven. Have a go at it. Ruin the suits. Oh, God. Oh, I tell you, the whole damned affair. Oh, dear. Here's a good one. Right. Good show, drummer. Here we go. Right. Some idiots left a plate on the stage. Never mind. No expense spared here. The music started. Where will it all end, I ask myself. Probably in the poorhouse. Oh, good gracious me. What a buffoon. What the hell's happened here? Love 15, 30 old juice. Juice. We're blinding with science tonight. Are we? Could have fooled me. Look at that, they all came back. Now here's a good one. the three-way split off. What the hell's happened here?
Good God! Oh, dear.
Now, dear, seems to be a hell of a lot of walking about, doesn't it? Oh, dear. That's up there. That's all right. Here's a good trick for you. Juggling backwards. I knew that'd get you. It got me as well. Right. Give it to him. Tonight. And now the four balls. Here we go. T for two. And you for me. Just T for two. And me for you. T for two. And me. Just me alone. Rocky down. Right. One, two, three, away you go.
Welcome to the Bunko Booth, where, as you know, each week we give away a lot of money in the hopes of winning it back again. Now, this week, the Bunko Booth takes a slightly different turn to the normal, because normally I stand here and I show you things where you can't win, and sometimes I lose a little, but in the end, I always get the money back. But several years ago, I was in Scarborough, and I saw a guy there playing a game called Spot. Now, it's very simple. All it was a big spot, and you had to cover it. And it looked so easy. He could do it a dream, but I kept getting it wrong. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let him demonstrate this game to you. I'm first of all going to give all this money to our lovely juror, a lady from our selected panel by the BBC. What's your name?
Julie.
Julie. And just come a little nearer, because, you know, we've specially had this guy washed just for you. He won't mind that. He's a friend of mine. Will you please welcome Nelson Elliott? Julie Nelson, and that's the spot.
Now, Julie, this is a lovely little game. You'll love it.
Not a lot.
But you'll love it. The idea is purely and simply to cover the circle with the five discs, and I show you exactly how to do it. The first disc you displace halfway. The second and third, you overlap them very, very carefully in the center. The fourth, you cross the center to cover it. And the last one, of course, fits halfway, covering the entire circle. That's all you have to do. But if you show the red, you lose, and you're not allowed to move the plate once it's down.
So, just backtracking there. If that bit of red, or even that bit of red, is left...
You lose.
You lose. But okay. You've seen how easy it is.
Julie, thank you. Take the time. Spend me £5. That's all I want of you. And if you win, we make it into 10. All right?
We make it into 10?
You are my partner.
I am his partner.
That's fine. Take your time halfway with your first one. That's fine. Cross them in the center, remember? Good. Overlap. When are you going to think you're going to win this? On these two corners?
I'm a bit worried about my tenor, Nelson.
Don't worry, you'll be right. What's this? Give it a stretch. Stretch it.
Ah,
put
what
it on
a shade.
I'll show you your mistake. Look, the shade lowered down, you'd have got that. So I tell you what I'm going to do. Look, halfway your first one, your second and third, look, just overlap that centre.
Watch closely, Julie.
Now cross them. And your last little devil, look, halfway. All right, so look, I'm going to leave that first one on for you. But this time, you sport me 10. You don't mind me doing that, do you?
No, not at all.
And if you win, you get 20. You don't mind that, do you?
I'm not sure yet.
I'll make ones.
You've left one on, you know.
Well, that's fine.
That's one.
And remember, cross them in the centre. Overlap.
Yes, because if you leave a bit in the middle, you lose as well. Just thought we'd tell you that when you're halfway through.
These two corners. That's fine.
She's doing well.
And you've got worse than when we started.
No, she can cover that. I'm going to have to pay out here.
You won't on this one.
What?
Look at the size.
What's the matter? Go on, drop it on.
What have you done? You need another disc. Listen, I'll tell you what I'm going to do with you. All right, we'll go a step further. If I leave you one, two on. You think you could put three on, look? One, two, and three.
Nelson, I think you'll fancy her. If you're leaving two on, before you finish, you'll be playing for her instead of me.
That can't be bad.
For £10.
Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot the money.
That's all right, I didn't.
Sorry about that. That's good. Don't move them, by the way. That's good. On the two corners. No moving, cheap fare.
She's moving it.
I like her.
She's moving it, dummy.
You've got it. No, look.
No, look. Now, you've got to agree with this, because sometimes it's a bit difficult for viewers. Look, bit of red. Do you agree?
Bit of red.
Bit of red. Bit do you agree? Red. Bit of red. Do you agree? You've lost. Do you agree?
You're not putting it away.
Well, I'm frightened. She's getting nearer every time now.
Right, this time, really, what I'm going to do is to leave you one, two...
Hey, show her that thing you did this afternoon with that.
And I'll even cover it for you. And that's got nothing to do with you, all right?
But there is a bit of red under there, isn't
there?
Of
course, but that's nothing to do with anybody.
Oh.
You don't mind?
No, it's just our money that's in box. I'm not nervous.
Three. Three. All I want you to do is to put one on there.
Three.
And, of course, one down there. Just those two. All right. Sport me that. 20. We'll make it the lot if she wins.
The lot if she wins?
The whole lot.
All right. Money. The lot if she wins.
All right, Julie. Come up with me.
Stage money.
I'll bring it up here. That's it. Beautiful. Lovely. All right, she's won.
She's what?
Stop counting. Thank you.
She has won. She has not won. She has not won, because look, there's a bit of red there and a bit of red there, and I did move it a little bit, but it doesn't really matter because you've lost a ball card. Do you agree you have lost? I love a good loser. And we get all the money back, but it doesn't really matter because you have won tonight's star prize, bottle of spot remover, in case you ever meet this again. Julie, you've been really good. Thank you very much for taking part in the game, but a particular thank you for showing us it. Nelson Elliott. Tremendous. ...150 years ago in Paris, a sensation was created by a very strange mechanical doll. And my next guest has recreated this masterpiece. And what you are about to see, well, you'll have my word. There's no electronics, no radio control, no electrical devices of any kind whatsoever. Ladies and gentlemen, Ioni. like to see is what I term mathemagical, because in the olden days, numbers had a secret meaning to people. They wore little amulets with numbers on, and that would ward off evil spirits. Well, that's what they believed. Now, over there, we have an enlarged amulet. There's a posh name for it. It's a big square, and we're going to make what is known as a magic square. Makes a change from being in the magic circle. Now, over here, we have a lovely young lady. What's your name?
Joan.
Okay, Joan, you have been given a box of balls, similar to those used in the game of bingo. They've all got little numbers on, yes? And you've had a quick look through, and in fact, you've had a long look through now, and you've seen that they've all got different numbers, all right? So it's not just a few numbers repeated, lots of different numbers, yep? Now we're going to make you very fit, Joan. I want you to hold the box up above your head without spilling any of the bingo balls. It's good game, good game. Right, and you get it up there, that's fine. Now, would you, madam, stand up? Thank you very much. Can you stand up? Of course you can, yes. What's your name?
Anne.
Anne. Oh, I'm awfully sorry. Didn't recognise you off the horse. Right, no, no, no. Oh, yes. Now, I want you to just look in the box. You two can see that they're all different numbers, right? But now what I want you to do is look away from the box and, in fact, close your eyes. And I want you to put one hand into the box and don't pick the first ball that comes to your mind. I just want you to rummage around and get a ball. I will look the other way on in order that I cannot have any knowledge at all of what the ball is you've chosen. Have you got one?
Yes.
You have?
Yes.
Okay. Now you can lower the rest of the balls down and I want you to just keep hold of that one ball and show it now to any camera. We've got lots of cameras around and I want you to just show it to a camera so the people at home, hold it up nice and steady. That's the main thing to do. So the number is pointing at a camera. Yeah? Have you done that?
Yeah.
Fine. Now, what, in fact, was the number that you chose? What was it, 41? Okay, 21, 1, 12, and 7. You see, what happens here is to create a magic square, one has to concentrate. Would you sit down but show the ball to somebody around you so they'll know that it's not a fiddle either? Now, by creating a magic square, you do it by the use of 16 numbers. The first four have already been chosen, and as you can see, are 21, 1, 12, and 7. And if you add those together, you will find the number adds up. 21, 22, 34, 41, you see? I don't know why I can't add it up, but I can't. But it does make 41. Four numbers chosen at random make the number 41. Now, it's very simple to find four numbers that make the number 41. The trick is to find four different numbers that make the number 41, like 11, 8, 20, and 2. Now, if you take 11, 8, 20, and 2 and add them together, you should arrive at a number 41. For example, 11 and 8 are 19, and 20 is 39, and 2 makes 41. That, of course, is a coincidence, because to do one of these things, you have to concentrate. You can't just do it off your head. It's another coincidence, of course, is this, that these four here make 41 as well, with a 22 there making 30 there and a 41 there, and a 28 there and a 13 there making 41 in the middle four. These four over here make 41 as well, with a 19 there added to the 22 here. Now, if in here we put a 5, a 10, a 3, and a 23. Now, a 5, a 10, and a 3, and a 23 will also make the number 41. But please, if you're going to try this, do concentrate. Don't just jabber on as if you could do it off your head, because it just won't work. It's a thing that you've got to really do a lot of thinking about. Like, for here, we've got a 5, a 10, a 3 is at 18, and a 23 there makes a 41. Not only does this row add up to 41, and this row add up to 41, and this row add up to 41, but all the numbers are completely different. And not only are they different, of course, you've got to remember that these four add up to 41, these four add up to 41, and these four add up to 41. Now, these four here also add up to 41 with a 28 and a 13 there. Now, you're probably wondering, why don't these four add up to 41? I don't know. However, it's probably because these two here, this 16, when added to that 25 there, will make 41. So that 25 there and that 16 there. Now, the trick is to find four more numbers along the bottom, like 4, 22, 6, and 9. Now, the 4, 22, and the 6, and 9 will also make the number 41. They won't. Yes, they will. And you've got to admit you had a free choice of any of the numbers in the box. Yep, of course you did. Now, the amazing thing is that this 26 here, when added to that, makes 32, and that makes 41 with the 9 on the bottom. Not only that, but if you add them upwards, you get 32, 4, 41. Coming down, you get 32 and 9 makes 41, 32 and 9 that way make 41, and 32 and 9 this way make 41. Not only that, my children, but not only do these four make 41, and these four make 41, and these four make 41, remembering, of course, that the middle four make 41, and these two over here, when added to these two over here, make 41, but now so do these four down here make 41 with a 26 when added to a 15. These four down here make 41 with a 13 added to a 28. These four down here with a 15 added to a 26 make 41, and not only that, but if you go down the diagonals, you get 27, 27, 37, 4 make 41, 29, 32, 9 there makes 41. not only the big diagonals, but these two little diagonals here, if added to the opposite two, you get a 14 there, and you get a 27 there, making 41, with a 12 there and a 29 there, making 41. Not only that, but if you make a smaller square, in other words, those nine numbers there, the four corners, when added together, will make the number 41, with a 23, 30, 30, and 40, 41. The same thing will happen if you take these nine squares here. These four will make 41, just as this square of nine will make 41 in the corners also. And not only that, if you take all those things into consideration, the whole thing, not adds up downwards, acrossways, all the combinations you can think of, but if you take the four corners, you've got a 21, 28, 37, and four down there makes 41. Now that's a magic square.
Daniels is currently appearing in his own show at the Prince of Wales Theatre, London.